Hi guys, and welcome once again to Jonesy's vlog. Apologies for this kind of lazy way of doing it, but to be honest, it's been a real long day at work, and I couldn't be arsed setting the tripod up, to be perfectly honest with you. So, yep, apologies for that, and also apologies for well, number one, the fact that this is going up a day later than what it was meant to. This weekend has not gone to plan at all. And things that were organised just haven't gone well. So yeah, this was meant to be going up last night, but due to various things, here it is now. And apologies for the lack of Jonesy's away day after Saturday, just due to technical issues with this camera and the battery deciding to not working. So that was pretty disappointing, but in the end, didn't really miss out on too much. So. Let's go straight to Saturday, really. You know, the majority of people, I think we were feeling a bit more confident going into the game, especially after what we'd seen against Huddersfield. But also still cautious, because at the end of the day, you know, Brentford, although recently have not been in great form, you know, losing the last match 4-0 away at Middlesbrough. And I believe they lost the game before that at home to Norwich. Or correct me if I'm wrong there. But at the end of the day, you know, Brentford are a good side. You know, their managers had them playing some really good football. You know, they're a very good sort of possession-keeping kind of team. So obviously, you know, playing away from home to a team like this, you still got to be wary and, you know, a little bit cautious about it as well. But I don't think we were expecting the performance that we saw from Leeds on Saturday. It was one of those where from the very start, from the very first whistle, we just never seemed like we were going to be in that game. You know, we never got started, and that was. I think that's what outdid us in the end, really. You know, the fact that in that first half we never looked in it, and like I say, we didn't get started. We didn't get in the match, and we never really recovered from that. I mean, second half we had a little spell of maybe about 15-20 minutes, but it wasn't enough. You know, it wasn't enough to come away with the points from a game like that. You know, just to have a little spell like that wasn't going to do it. And it was hard to put your finger on what went wrong, really. Basically everything that we'd seen against Huddersfield that came off and that was working just didn't come off and didn't work in this match. You know, there weren't that many changes to the team. I mean, there was only, to the starting 11, there was only Byram that are coming for Berardi, obviously, because of the suspension. And just maybe the fact that the bench was a little bit weaker than usual. You know, Billy Sharp and Adrian wasn't on there. We had Morrison and Tong, you know, players like that on the bench. But, you know, that shouldn't have made any difference to our playing style and how we were playing. I mean, let's not take anything away from Brentford. You know, like I say, they are a really good footballing team, and that showed on Saturday. You know, they completely bossed the game from start to finish, pretty much. Their midfield completely outfought our midfield. You know, one of our ex-players, Jonathan Douglas, sort of came back to haunt us a little bit. He ran the show pretty much for them. I think he got their man of the match, and fully deserved as well. And we never contained that threat from him. You know, we never seemed to, you know, put anyone on him. You know, in midfield, we couldn't, we didn't stop him. You know, he was taking full control of the game, and we failed to stop that. And it just, like I say, it never got going. We didn't look as threatening going forward. Dakara and Antonucci were not their usual selves up front. You know, Lewis Cook, for all the fantastic games he's had recently, he wasn't on form. But I mean, for such a young lad, you know, he's bound to have some bad games. You know, we can't expect that the level of performance that he's been given you know, for us every single game throughout the whole season. There was also Mowat, who was in for Slot, who was on the bench. And again, you know, he was coming back from this injury, and you know, he didn't have a bad game, but you know, there was nothing, there was just nothing happening from that midfield. You know, the passing just wasn't quite there this time round, and our movement and our sort of shape just, for whatever reason, just was not what it was against Huddersfield. We seem to be concentrating on attacking the wings on Saturday, which is something we haven't been doing, you know, so far this season, and that clearly just didn't work out and wasn't working out. You know, any of the balls that were sort of going upfield, you know, Dakara wasn't holding up like he usually does, or wasn't finding the passes. You know, the support didn't seem to be there like usual. And just all round, I mean, for me, you know, I'm not wanting to overreact, you know, to this defeat like some fans were on Saturday. You know, we no one was really expecting us to keep that level of football up for the rest of the season. You know, we're bound to have off days, and you know, I'm willing to just kind of write it off as one of those days, and just hopefully it won't continue. And I certainly don't want to be sort of blaming, you know, Milanic, because a lot of people were saying, well, you know, it's no coincidence as soon as this new guy is in, you know, we have a poor performance, which I think is really unfair on the guy, and already unnecessary pressure has been put on him. You know, I'm not saying mistakes weren't made with the team and the selection and the formation, because I didn't think we were at the best strength that we could have been, and the way we'd set up for the match was just wrong. It was a mistake. But you know, we there's no need to go overboard with this defeat. But you know, of course it's disappointing. You it's spent what, about 40, 50 quid, you know, on a very long journey down to Brentford, and you know, we're given, you know, apart from the penalty miss, there was very little to shout about. It was just one of those days where nothing was going to go right. One other thing I could probably question was the lack of Neil Redfern at the game. By all accounts, I think he was meant to be there, but for whatever reason, it was decided that he was to take charge of one of the youth games that was on that day. But I personally feel like that was a mistake. I would have felt a lot better if he would have been, you know, on the touchline and on the bench for that match. I mean, I was speaking to my dad about it, and we personally feel that maybe just for this first match, because, you know, Darko Milanic's only been in the country for, what, a week now, is it? Only got to take a few training sessions, so he's not bound to know the team straight away. You know, he's going to have been struggling, you know, a little bit getting to know the squad. So we feel maybe just for this first match, maybe he should have sat up in the stands and still had Redders on the touchline, kind of running things just to begin with. I felt that would have been a better introduction for him. But, you know, whether that was Milic's idea, Chelino's, Red, you know, who knows, you know, Redfern might have preferred to have taken the youth team, you know. We don't know what goes on behind the scenes with that kind of stuff. But personally, that's how I'd have wanted to see it sort of, you know, happen on Saturday. You know, the only really bright spot for us was Silvestri again, showing what a top-class keeper he really is, and that he's going to be probably one of our biggest assets this season. You know, if it wasn't for him, it could quite easily have been 4 or 5-0 to Brentford, who, like I say, just completely dominated and bossed us throughout the game and deserved their victory. But yeah, if it wasn't for Silvestri, then our goal difference would have been looking pretty shabby again, to be honest. So yeah, that's it to say about the match, really. You know, it really was a disappointing afternoon, but it doesn't go further than that for me. I don't think there needs to be any big inquests about it. You know, for me, hopefully it was just an off day, one of those things that happens, and just come back, you know, fighting stronger against Reading on Wednesday night, which I'm looking forward to. Hope for a little bit of revenge after last season's Well, disappointing result down at Reading, obviously, with it being such a last-minute winner, literally the last kick of the game, and then the pretty humiliating defeat at home again, which was midweek. So I hope we don't have to suffer anything like that again. So yeah, that's all I have to say then, really, guys. So let me know your thoughts on the game. If there were any of you out there who were at the game like me, I did manage to meet quite a few of you down there, which was pretty nice. But yeah, let me know your thoughts on the game, either on here or at my Twitter, @ChrisJonesLUFC. And also let me know your predictions ahead of the game against Reading on Wednesday night. What you think the team should be, any changes to what it was on Saturday. And yeah, just keep any comments about anything coming in. So yeah, as always, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you all very soon.